St. Timothy's families. So kids, I am so excited you're here to join us in our Sunday worship. If you're doing this on any other day of the week, that's totally fine too. You can worship God whenever you want to. So in our video today, it's gonna be as follows. We're gonna start with our memory verse, and then we're gonna move on down and we're gonna do a worship song together. So I hope you join me. Find a nice big area where you can dance around and get goofy. After the worship song, we're gonna start getting into our message. Right? The lesson God has for us. The lesson God has for us today. After that, we're gonna play a game. Our game will go over instructions and supplies that you will need. After our game, we're gonna participate and do a craft together. You can join me as I do the craft in the video or do the craft later on in the week. After the craft, I'm gonna test you on that memory verse. See how many fill in the blanks you can get. And then we'll close with our prayer. All right, guys, enjoy this video and enjoy your worship.
Therefore, do not be anxious, saying, "What shall we eat?" Or, "What shall we drink?" Or, "What shall we wear?" For the Gentiles seek after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them all. Matthew 6:31-32.
Now it's your turn. Why don't you try saying the memory verse? Ready? Go.
Thank you.
Welcome back, St. Tim's kids, to our third stop of our summer road trip. I'm going to give you a second. Where do you think we've stopped today? It's one of my favorite things to do on a road trip. Well, we're at our campground. We've stopped to go camping. Have you guys ever been on a campout? How many of you have camped in a tent? What about in a trailer or an RV? Who has camped many times with their families and loved it? Who here hates camping and who will never ever go back out camping as long as you live? Some people love it, some people hate it. Did you know that California has 280 state parks? A collection of landscapes ranging from the Sierra Nevada mountains to redwood forests to broad sandy beaches. Within those, there are about 13,000 campsites at 105 parks with camping for tents, RVs, and in cabins. Camping has always been a popular way to vacation for some people. The good thing about camping is it allows you to enjoy the great outdoors. It gets you away from the comforts of home and hotels. It separates you from TV and the internet and video games. It puts you close to nature, where you can hike and fish and look for birds. The bad part about camping is that it takes place outdoors. There's no TV, no internet, and no video games. There's rain, heat, humidity, sweating, getting dirty. There's not so great showers and sometimes gross bathrooms. And there are bugs. Lots and lots of bugs. Bugs that crawl, get into everything. I just don't like bugs. What are you guys looking at? Is there something in my hair? Anyways, there's also bears, squirrels, coyotes, and everybody's favorite, snakes. Camping can either be a joy or a nightmare, and a lot of it depends on our own preparations. If you plan ahead, you can have everything on hand to make your camping trip very successful and fun. That means you need to have food, water, sleeping bags, sunscreen, maps, flashlights, cookware, something to help you cook or start a fire, and many more things. Can you think of other things you would take camping? If you're going to need it out in the woods, you better pack it at home or you will be lost without it. Buddy and I love to camp. He's been camping in the redwood forest. It was kind of funny. When we first went camping, in the first 2 minutes of him being there, he rolled his entire face in mud and had to get a little bath. Getting dirty. If you're going to go hiking or camping, you're gonna need a few things. And Buddy and I always take our first aid kit with us. In this first aid kit, there are some things that are going to help us in case we get injured or lost, hungry, if we need water, we're going out in the sun and playing. I'm going to show you what's in here. In our first aid kit, we have a granola bar. This one's strawberry flavor, one of my favorites. This granola bar is in case we're hiking or camping and we get really hungry. We can stop and have a quick snack so that we have energy to keep going. Another thing you're going to need in your kit is water. I don't have it in here, but I have my water bottle on the campgrounds. The next thing I have in my emergency camping kit is, can you guess what it is? It's a flashlight. This is to help you if you get lost along the way, or if you want to tell spooky stories around the campfire. The next thing in my emergency kit is, in case you get injured, a little scratch, maybe you got a bug bite, you can use these Band-Aids. They're gonna help protect you from anything on the outside world that could hurt you. I have my favorite princesses and, of course, Frozen with Olaf there. Next, I have some special ointment in case you get bit by those bugs we were talking about earlier. It helps it not hurt as much. And of course, something I carry around everywhere I go, some hand sanitizer in case your hands get a little dirty. And the last thing I have in my kit is a phone, okay? You might have a phone or maybe a walkie-talkie or even a whistle. Something to help you in case you're lost and someone needs to find you or you have to call somebody for help. When we go camping, it's up to us to bring the provisions we need to have a successful camping trip. But sometimes in life, we need help. We need God to step in and give us what we need. Sometimes we can prepare for the challenges in our lives. We can plan ahead, pack what we need for the next leg of our journey. But what happens when you end up someplace unexpected? What if you took a turn that you didn't plan to take and you find yourself lost or in need of help? Today's Bible story reminds us that in those difficult times, God will be faithful and He will provide for us. Let's check in with our friends, the Israelites, as they make their way into the wilderness. They had just escaped Pharaoh and made it through the Red Sea through God's miracle. Now they're in the wilderness. And in spite of having God leading the way, the Israelites were still complaining. The people were hungry. They needed food. They needed a lot of it. Once again, the people began to grumble. Some even say they would have been better off staying in slavery, just like they did at the Red Sea. Fortunately for the Israelites, God has compassion on them. God sent quail, which is a type of bird, by the thousands into their camps. The people captured the quails, and finally they had some meat to eat. God also gave them manna, a flaky food substance that they could use to turn into breads and other staples. God gave them manna every day, except on the Sabbath day, and He always told them to just take enough. If they took too much, the manna would be rotten the next day. God wanted them to trust Him, to keep giving the manna every day. God knows our needs before we ask. God wants us to ask, and He wants to provide for us. When we find ourselves in need, we can trust God to give us the things we need. Camping is a challenge. Sometimes when you're out in the woods, you have to endure a lot of discomfort. Heat, cold, rain, wind, bugs. They can all make a fun night in the woods turn sour. But even on the worst of nights, we can find reasons to be thankful. We have a tent to keep us out of the elements. We have food, we have water, we have the beautiful scenery to enjoy, and we have the company of good friends and family. Sometimes, life can be even more difficult than camping. We find ourselves in some difficult situations, some storms that we feel like will never end. We wonder how we got there and how we're ever going to get out. Isn't it good to know we serve a God who knows exactly what we need and will give it to us at the right time when we need it? Just as He did for Israel, providing manna and quail when they were hungry, God can bless us in ways we never imagined He would. God knows our needs before we even ask, but God still wants us to ask. He wants us to say, God, I know You provide, I trust You. Give me what I need. Can you practice saying that right now? When you trust God in big and little things, He will always answer and always provide. God is powerful, and He will always give us the things we need. Thank God every day for the small things He has given you. What small thing has God provided for you today? And trust Him to always meet our needs. St. Timothy's, I have a special challenge for you this week. Something to do by yourself, with your siblings, or maybe with your parents too. I want you to try to go camping at your own house. Now, you can go camping in your living room and build a special fort out of sheets and blankets, or you can have your parents help and set up a tent outside so you can be outside and camp. So that's my challenge. Let's go camping in our own house. We're in the hat. Guess what time it is? Game time. For this game, it's probably a game that you've heard before, but we're putting a camping twist on it. This game is called the Sleeping Bag Race. Now, you can use a sleeping bag, or you can stick to a pillowcase, whatever works for you. Now, you can compete with yourself and see how fast you can go, try to get your fastest time, or you can compete with your brother, sister, parents, aunt, uncle, somebody in your house, and you're gonna race and see who can hop in your sleeping bag the fastest. So you're gonna need to make a start line, determine where you're all starting, and create a finish line. I'm gonna do this in my front yard and race against one of my friends, and we're gonna see who wins. So let's get started. Get your sleeping bags revved up, and let's go race. For today's craft, we're going to be creating our own little campsite using food you can eat. So I have gotten some toothpicks, some mini marshmallows, frosting, gummy bears, gummy worms, some pretzel sticks, and we're going to be building a mini campsite so you can use frosting for the ground, build a tent out of marshmallows and toothpicks. I even have some Twizzlers in there so you can build a fake little fire. Think of it like a gingerbread house, but camping version. Thank you.
Now it's time to test your knowledge. Let's see how many fill-in-the-blanks you can complete from our memory verse this week.
Today's prayer is going to be a little different. We are going to thank God for something He has done in our lives. So on the count of three, let's say something out loud that we are so thankful for. Ready? One, two, three.
Sanctum's kids, thank you for joining me on our third stop. Thanks for going camping with me. Next week, we're going to be stopping somewhere special. And I want you to try to guess where we're going. Always exciting. I hope to see you next week, and thank you for joining me on our summer road trip.